Hello and welcome back to the PolyKit channel. I've been lucky lately, getting hold of old and broken synthesizers. In my last video I fixed an old Italian drum machine. This time I acquired a non-working Korg Poly 6 from 1981. The Korg Poly 6 has 6 voices with a single oscillator on each voice, made out of discrete components. It offers a saw and square output with pulse width modulation. Each voice has an additional sub-oscillator going 1 or 2 octaves down. The voltage-controlled filter is based on the SSM2044 integrated circuit, a successor of the chip used in the first versions of the Prophet 5. It has 1 ADSR per voice and uses the SSM2056 integrated circuit. The Korg Poly 6 was sold for around $1,000 in 1981, a real bargain at the time. It targeted the Prophet 5, even if it was not a direct match. Astonishing 50,000 units were sold. In addition, it has 1 LFO which can control VCO, VCF or VCA. There is an effect section, although it only got mono output. It has the ability to store 32 patches, and that was rather new at the time. To complete the feature list, the synthesizer has a simple arpeggiator with up, down and up, down functionality over 1 or 2 octaves or the full range. There's a hold, chord memory and unison mode for key voice assignment. It has no MIDI in or output. The MIDI 1.0 standard was introduced in 1982 by Dave Smith from Sequential Circuits and Ikutaro Kakehashi from Roland. It is fascinating that this standard is still used in today's electronic instruments 40 years later. Later in this video I will look into adding a MIDI interface to this great machine to make it even more usable and fitting into the present and sync it up with other gear. Also, if you're interested in how to tune a Korg Poly 6, there are chapter marks and you can skip right to it. If you enjoy content like this, please subscribe to the channel and hit the like button. This really helps the channel and motivates me on doing more videos like this. For its age of over 40 years, it's in a pretty good condition on the outside. Korg synthesizers from that time are known for their leaking memory batteries, destroying the whole CPU board. So I hope I would be lucky to get it back into a working state. After powering it up for the first time, it turns on but made no sound at all. It seems controls were working except of the key assignment section and the keyboard itself. Okay, let's open it up and take a look inside. After opening it up, it shows that there is an old MIDI extension installed, which is basically connected to every key on the keyboard. It has some multiplexing logic, a control board and an additional power supply. I decided to remove it completely and replace it with a modern MIDI extension, which surely offers more options of controlling the synthesizer and also has MIDI output. After removing everything, the key assignment section and the keyboard started to work. In the schematics you can see that the keyboard and the key assignment section are connected to the same input pins on the 8049 microcontroller, which is responsible for the key assignment. That means that the old MIDI installation caused a short circuit or some other malfunction on the keyboard assignment bus. After this I tried to tune the synthesizer, but for whatever reason it was not possible to change the tuning of the upper octaves. Before going on, I decided to first replace all electrolytic capacitors and give everything a good clean. After replacing all capacitors, cleaning it up and putting it back together, it was still not possible to bring the synthesizer into tune. After googling around a bit, it turned out that many Poly 6s are suffering from a bad optocoupler, which is controlling the feedback loop of the exponential converter. The exponential converter is needed to convert a linear voltage change to an exponential one, which is controlling the pitch of the voices. An exponential voltage curve is needed to double frequency in every octave. The voltage is then multiplexed to the voice that is currently playing and held by a capacitor to keep the pitch of the oscillator stable. If you have problems getting your Poly 6 into tune, it is most likely because of this problem. Other signs for a bad optocoupler are no change of pitch when turning VR2 and a voltage around minus 13 volts on pin 7 of IC18. I removed the optocoupler and put in an IC socket to be more flexible on trying out replacement options. The original P1501 is very hard to source at incredible prices. Luckily, there is a replacement for this part. The Vectrol VTL5C9 is a great replacement, which is easy to find. I already had this part in stock for my DIY synthesizer builds. After putting the Vectrol in, it was rather easy to get the synthesizer into tune. First, all global parameters and the first voice are brought into tune. After this, all other voices are tuned without touching the global parameters again. There's a small LED identifying the voice that is currently playing. You need a tuning device for this process. An instrument tuning app for your mobile device should work as well. Now to the tuning procedure. Set the octave switch to 4 and turn off all modulation or detuning. First we are going to tune voice 0, play key C5, that's the second top C, and adjust VR11 until you have exactly C7 in tune. If VR11 is far off from center, try to adjust VR2. Now play C2, that's the second lowest C, and adjust VR1 until you have it in tune. Repeat these both steps for voice 0 until both C notes are in tune. Now we are going for the global adjustment, this is still for voice 0. Play C3 and adjust VR15 as close as possible. Next play D-sharp 4 and E4 and adjust VR14 until they are in tune. Repeat both steps to get as close as possible. Repeat the whole procedure until C5, C2 and C3 are in tune. Set the octave switch to 16 and adjust VR3 to get C2 into tune. Try to keep VR10 at the center position. Repeat everything until voice 0 is in tune. After this, we are going to tune the other voices and not touching the global trim pots again. This is the same procedure for voices 1 to 5. Set octave switch to 4 and get C5 into tune by adjusting VR11. Set octave range to 16 and adjust C2 by changing VR10. Repeat this for all left voices. After fiddling around a bit, I got used to the procedure and was able to get the synthesizer in tune. I'm going to link a detailed description on the tuning process and also the service manual below. The MIDI extension is easy to install and it is possible to do so without any soldering at all. It replaces the whole key assignment processor and offers MIDI input and output. With some additional soldering and resistors, it is possible to control parameters like filter cutoff and pitch bend. I decided to replace the power cable as well, so no drilling is needed for the MIDI connectors and the synthesizer has a nice power plug now. We'll be right back. The restoration of the Cogpoly 6 has been a great success. It has been fixed by removing the old MIDI extension and replacing the broken optocoupler. In addition, I replaced all electrolytic capacitors, cleaned the keyboard and all other parts of the synthesizer. All voices have been tuned, and with the MIDI extension it now integrates into my setup and even offers control of some parameters. Overall, it's in a great shape and will work for many years to come. Alright, that's all for today. Stay tuned for upcoming videos. Thanks for watching and bye for now.